We decided to take a side trip before starting the Gibb River Road down to Purnululu National Park to visit the Bungle Bungles. This road goes through Mabel Down Station. It's not terribly well maintained. It's about 78 kilometres and just expect it to take a good couple of hours. There's lots of traffic at times going along it. There's cattle in the middle of the road. Look, it's windy, the camber's all over the show, and it's incredibly corrugated at times, but it's by no means the worst road that we've been on, but we just wanted to lay it out there for you so that you're aware of what the road was like. So if you've got kids in the car, just take your time and expect that it's going to take a good couple of hours.
After staying at camp for the night, we got away early this morning. This is the south end of the ranges, and we're just driving along around a windy corrugated road, heading around to the first side of the Bungle Bungles and the beehive shaped sandstone rocks. It's a pretty awesome view. It would have to be on our top 10, I reckon, of places we've been in the world, as far as just the scenery and the rock escarpment. It's pretty incredible.
The first walk we took was Dome's Loop. This is a very easy grade and it's quite a short loop. It just meanders through a sandy track and a few rocks in between the domes, so you get to get a good look at the different layers and just the immense size of them. So that's a really easy one for most abilities, I would say. From Dome's Loop you can carry on to the Cathedral Gorge Trail, which most people do because Dome's Loop itself is so short. The track is really good. We didn't time it, but it probably took us about an hour to get up and back. You'll want to spend a bit of time up there as well because it's so spectacular. The trail itself is really easy. It's just walking up through dry riverbed. There's a bit of sand at times, and occasionally there was a couple of trickier pieces with rails and ladders, but that was pretty easy too.
This is Cathedral Gorge and it is spectacular.
Our timing was great and we got Cathedral Gorge to ourselves for about 20 minutes. At that point we wandered back out and then added about another 30 minutes onto our track by heading up to Pickaninny Lookout across the dry riverbed. This was a really great vantage lookout point back over the domes that we'd previously wandered around. We just sat having lunch. The Bungle Bungles, been up to the lookout and there's no one around here, which is great. So we've just found a shady spot. Can show you around.
Picked up the rest of the kids that we'd left behind.
Pretty spectacular view. Yep, we left the kids. They got too hot to climb up to the lookout, so we just left them under a tree. We carried on up. Quality parenting. They were happy. I had Hunter on my back. They were just the older kids. Summer's munching her salad wrap. The northern end of the national park has a variety of walks also. We really had to pick and choose what walks we could do as they needed to be of shorter duration with the kids. We picked Echidna Chasm, which was probably about maybe 2 km up and 2 km back, and it was beautiful with the red escarpments in the afternoon light. If you're planning to do it, they actually say the optimum time to go is 11 a.m. where you're getting the sun rays shining right down into the narrowings of the chasm. The kids really enjoyed it. As you can see, it was just a pebbly rock pretty much the whole way, and the narrowing really made for fantastic fun for the kids, and it was really beautiful. Although we did prefer the southern end with all the Bungle Bungle, the beehive formations, but this was great for something different. This is our setup at Willardi Campground at the southern end. This campground can only be booked online prior to your arrival, and because of that it's a lot quieter and probably preferable. So make sure you get that organised if you're wanting to stay. It's basic facilities, just a long drop toilets, and there is running water, but it needs to be boiled before you drink it. There's another campground at the northern end called Kurrajong Campground, and it's quite busy because you can just book it and stay at it once you arrive at the visitor centre. The third option for those towing on-road or only semi-off-road vans is of course the campground right out at the main road before you start driving into Purnululu National Park, and that's a perfect option for those that want to unhook and just drive in with the car for the day. The airfield's also there for the helicopter scenic flights, so that's a great campground if people are planning on just doing that instead.